But October was the 9th driest month in Iowa history.
And tonight in our top story, Angie Hunt shows us how the dry conditions are affecting water levels at places like Saylorville Lake.
Well, just this spring, we were out here at Saylorville talking about the high lake levels and the concern for flooding. Now this fall, it's a completely different story.
This is what it looked like in early June, when as much as 72,000 gallons of water were flowing out of Saylorville Lake every second.
If you know what a white rapid water is, it's just like that coming through, and it's real strong and powerful.
Even more powerful when you compare it to these images from the floods of 2010, when the outflow was double what it was this spring. Now compare that with the levels this fall.
Yeah, a lot of people come out here just to look at the water, you know, look at the water level, and I guess everybody's just amazed about how much it's dropped.
The Army Corps of Engineers is releasing around 200 to 250 cubic feet per second. For comparison, that's around 1,900 gallons.
I mean, it's just a trickle right now. And again, that's, you know, right now we're basically letting out what's coming into the lake.
But Rose says there's not a lot of water flowing into the lake from rivers and streams, as you can see from the many exposed sandbars along the lake's shore. That's why boating is not recommended north of the mile-long bridge near Polk City.
They can get stuck, and we've had several stuck that we've had to go rescue. Local agencies have had to go rescue them.
It's also created problems, Rose says, getting lake levels up for waterfowl migration. No surprise, according to the state climatologist, the last 2 months were the driest September and October since 1953.
Right now, we don't have no water. It's just everything's drying out.
And according to the state climatologist, the outlook for November is for wetter than usual conditions, but also warmer than normal temperatures. Angie Hunt, KCCI News Channel 8, Iowa's news leader.